Good evening, doctors. Welcome again. Our today's topic is 1000 high yield MCQs before your NEET PG exam. That will very, very high yield from recent MCQs. These are very high yield. You definitely going to receive some questions from your exam, from this in your exam. Okay, let's start with a question number one. At what period does tuberculosis flare up most commonly in a pregnant female, pregnant patient? This is a recent question. It is a definitely a probability to came in an exam. So answer here is, option is first trimester, second trimester, third trimester, or puerperium. During puerperium is a chance of very, very high yield of tuberculosis. Okay, I hope till clear this. Now, question number second. All of the following are feature of prematurity. Feature of prematurity in neonates, except there is no crease on sole. Yes, true. Abundant lunego. Yes, lanugo. Thick ear cartilage. No, guys, there is no thick ear cartilage. So answer is C, empty scrotum. Yes, but I'm going to explain why. So let's discuss. In ear, in a premature neonate, soft and flat with ear cartilage, being digescent and plain and not thick. This is not thick. Okay, remember, first, a baby small in size. Yes, he's definitely small, less than 47 centimeter long. Head is relatively large in such babies. Sutures are widely separated and fontanelle are large. So remember, guys, this line, because MCQ will not came same, but it can be come from this line. Remember, from this theory. Okay. Now, which of these surgical procedure, this is surgical procedure, has the highest incidence of ureteric injury? So Wortham's hysterectomy is the answer. Vaginal hysterectomy is less chance of ureteric injury. Abdominal, yes, but Wortham's hysterectomy is more chance of ureteric injury. So hope till here it's clear. Now let's move on the next page. Let's discuss. Okay, sorry guys. Yeah, normally developing 10 month old child, 10 महीने का बच्चा, should be able to do all of the following except 10 month. Stand alone, bear walk in 9 month, and in 10 month, yes, he can stand alone. Play pick and boo, yes. Pick up plate and with thumb and index finger, yes, he can. Even we know pincer grasp in which month? 9 months, okay. But a build of tower of 3 to 4 cubes is not able to done by 10 months old child. Okay, 6 cubes made by 2 years, 9 cubes by 3 years. So this is not by 10 months child. Okay, let's move another question. Which of the following raised in PCOD, polycystic ovarian disease? As we know very well, we discussed a lot of time, luteinizing hormone increase during PCOD. This is very, very high yield MCQ, very, very high yield. So FSH and LH ratio is reverse in PCOD, remember. Serum testosterone increases. We will discuss in further questions, MCQs. Okay, another. Following are characteristic of autism, except this is a psychiatric disorder we found mainly in children's. They give onset after asking except. Onset after 6 years of age, no. So answer is this. Onset is 2 to 3 years of age, as I put. Repetitive behavior, yes. Delayed language development, yes. Severe deficit in social interaction, we see, yes, in autism. But not seen is 6 year age. Age is 2 to 3 years onset of autism. Hope this question will clear for you now. Which vitamin deficient most common seen in pregnant mother who is on phenytoin therapy? Phenytoin therapy causes folic acid deficiency. Let's discuss. Folic acid absorption decrease and its excretion increase. Those using phenytoin they have other vitamin deficiency also, like vitamin D and vitamin K. So I hope till here it's clear. Now move on next question with next page. Okay. Earliest indicator of response after starting iron in a 6-year-old girl with iron deficiency. In this option, the right answer is reticulocyte increase. But if you are going to sit in an exam, you think maybe the option this was given, but other was appetite improvement and irritability were given, then go for appetite improvement and irritability. This is a series. First, we give iron therapy, then improvement in appetite and decrease improvement in irritability. Second improvement is initial bone marrow response. Then third one is increased reticulocyte. But these two options are not there. So answer is increased reticulocyte count. Hemoglobin level return to normal. Body iron stores going to be normal, like serum ferritin is last. So hope this question is clear for you. Now, which of the following ovarian tumor is most prone to undergo torsion during pregnancy? This is dermoid cyst. Dermoid cyst is the most common tumor which undergo torsion during pregnancy. So I hope it's clear for you. Now, which of the congenital malformation can be diagnosed in first trimester? That is anencephaly. Let's discuss. In first trimester, we see diagnose anencephaly on USG, we can say ultrasonography. Anencephaly, what is it? Absence of major part of brains and skull. Okay. Acrania is also, we can diagnose in first trimester, like flat bones, cranial vault part and income and complete absent. Okay. Now, exencephaly, it's brain outside skull. Brain is outside the skull. So guys, have a good day. Goodbye. That's all for today. If you have any queries, any question, you can ask me. And if you still not subscribe my channel, subscribe it. And if you like this video, please put like on it. Total 100 parts I'm going to put 1000 MCQs. Thank you. Good day and goodbye.